tough loss yesterday. Guys worked extremely hard in preparation for the ball game and didn't get the results we wanted. But we have a resilient group. We're looking forward to bouncing back and lining up this next weekend and getting back on the field and working hard to get a win. But tough loss for sure.
Despite the loss, what did you see out of your defense and the way he was able to respond to the coaching, work the game plan, and do what it did to what's a very dynamic offense?
Yeah. You know, John, when we met with the players earlier this afternoon, we just talked about the resiliency that they showed and how they adapted to the game plan and then took it to the game. Sometimes when you put a plan together, it doesn't always show up on Sundays, and especially one of this nature. It was kind of unique in some of the things we had to get done because of the offense, style offense. But our guys grasped it. They worked extremely hard, both in the classroom and on the field. And they played physical. They played tough. They really got after it. And, you know, just made you proud just watching them play. I mean, they fought and battled throughout the game. Not that we were surprised. You know, we've seen that throughout the year. But that was a different style offense, and they rose to the challenge.
Do you think this, from a confidence perspective, I mean, to know that you can, that this unit can do that against that defense, does it build confidence in knowing that maybe they could, if they follow the same studies and whatever approach, that this can carry over and, you know, really lift them as a defense, as a playoff caliber defense?
Well, anytime you work as hard as our guys did throughout the week and they have throughout the season, and then you go out and play as well as they did in certain situations, it definitely bolsters your confidence. But in our league, every week is different. So it'll be a different approach in some ways this week because of a different style of offense, and you have to kind of reset. But for sure, there are some things we can draw on from that game, and they will draw on, that will build confidence. But it's a different week, different style offense, different approach. But we do have some things that we can build on.
Obviously, it's a total team effort, but how important is Matt Milano to what you guys do in a game like that against a quarterback?
Well, Matt's been a valuable piece for us throughout the year and, you know, going back to last season when he really kind of came into his own. So to have him back healthy and playing at a high level is a big deal because he's such a versatile player, a guy who can cover tight ends and man coverage without any help, can do the same thing with running backs, and he's a good blitzer, and he tackles well, and he plays with an attitude as well. So he's a valuable piece to what we do, but we got a number of guys that help, you know, make the puzzle successful, and he's a big part of our success. Yeah.
In his background and late round pick that, you know, didn't take him too long, I guess, to become a big part of what you guys do.
Yeah. What I remember, Matt, is all the conversation about the injuries he had coming out. There was a lot of conversation. I think he was struggling with hamstrings at the time. And as you know, he's had a little bit of that to prop up at times here as well. And so that was the big discussion. You know, will he be one of those guys who will always be injured? And, you know, you see flashes and then he's out for a long period of time. And he's worked extremely hard to overcome some of those injury questions that we had coming out, and I'm sure that had a lot to do with him going as late as he did, but also the hybrid factor. You know, we were trying to project him as a three-down linebacker who could do it all, you know, cover, blitz, tackle. You know, but you saw those qualities as a safety/linebacker. Could he do it at our level? Combine that with the injuries. I mean, that was the conversation. Can he do it? And I'm glad we took him. He's definitely turned out to be a very, very good player.
He's a big talker, so how do you shut him up?
A big talker.
How do you shut him up?
Yeah. No, that's not Matt. Yeah.
How do you know when he's excited about something?
You know, the guys tease him all the time, John. Jerry Hughes and Shaq Lawson, all those guys, they give him a hard time in the huddle and always razz him. And he has a great attitude, great approach. He doesn't let that stuff affect him, but you know, I mean, you just watch the way he plays, the intensity that he plays with, the way he runs around. You know, he loves the game and has a passion for it. And but the guys, they give him a hard time about his demeanor. And but he handles it extremely well.
We know that Tremaine is very athletic and all the things he can do. Was yesterday one of the more physical games you've seen him play?
So that's exactly what Bob Babich and the rest of our coaching staff was talking about, how physical he played yesterday. That was really, really good to see. He's been coming along in that area. You know, he has a really good grasp of what we're trying to do on defense, and that was the other part we keep urging him to play more physical. And yesterday, I mean, he did it. I mean, he used his hands and you know, knocked those offensive linemen around and tackle well and played with some emotion. It was great to see. It was good for our defense. When you, one of your leaders plays the way he played, it's kind of infectious. It affects everybody. So it was really good to see. I think for all of our guys, not, I can't speak for the whole team, but I just know on our side of the ball, it's more about our team, and it's always about our team and what we can do to help our team succeed. And when we don't succeed as a team, you know, we all feel it. It hurts. And no matter what we've done on special teams or what we've done on defense or offense, it's about our team. And the goal is to get a win. And when that doesn't happen, it doesn't matter what kind of statistics you've had. You're disappointed. You know, we have bigger goals than to just have good statistics. We want to win and, you know, bring a championship to Buffalo. So it hurts when things don't work out as a team.
I know you're just getting into the Steelers film, but how has Duck Hodges been doing it? You know, what do you see from him?
See a guy who, in a little bit of tape that I watched, who seems to be very composed for the amount of experience he has. And he's making some plays with his arm, but he also is making some plays with his feet. He scrambled and picked up some first downs, showed some athletic ability, but his poise and composure, that's what kind of stands out. He looks like a guy who has done this a lot longer than his experience actually shows. So he'll be a guy we'll have to contend with, but they've got some other weapons on offense also that will help what he has to get done. But his composure and his poise is kind of what stands out.
Are you surprised? Right. Are you surprised Sir Davis didn't get an interception after picking up those play sheets?
Yeah, that was pretty good. I wish he had got some tips that would have helped us to get some more takeaways. But that was pretty cool by him. Yeah, sure. So.